Welcome to Learn Today. Let us study first chapter of maths, 8th standard, rational and irrational numbers. Rational and irrational numbers. So numbers are classified, you can see in different way. That is number one, natural number, whole number, integers, and rational number. There are irrational number also. So natural numbers are those number we can see 1, 2, 3, 4. This all numbers are natural. We are using regularly. And whole number, you have 0 in beginning. So 0, 1, 2, 3, these are whole number. But if you are going for integers, then from 0 ke left side or right side. Right side of 0, you have positive numbers, and left side of 0, you have negative numbers. So from 0, 1, 2, 3, but if you will go on a back side, the reverse of 0, you will find minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So these are integers. Now our 8th standard portion have rational numbers. Rational numbers are those number which have numerators and denominators. Numerators means this upon the line, and denominator means below the line. So these are numerator and denominator. So if any number have numerator and denominator, they can be called as rational number. M above the line, numerator below the line, denominator. So rational number can be in a form of numerator and denominator. But important thing is that numerator can be any number or zero, but denominator here below the line number cannot be zero. It cannot be zero. Ye zero nahi ho sakta. Here you can see, if you have any number 5 upon 0, this is not a rational number. But you have 5, then it is a rational number, because 5 can be written as 5 upon 1. So 5 is a rational number, but it is not a rational number. So here you can get the explanation of rational number. Let's go further and study how to get this rational number on number line. So here you can see example how to frame this numbers 7 upon 3, 2, minus 2 upon 3. These are all rational number. We have to show these numbers on number line. So here you can see how to draw a number line. So let us draw a number line. So here you can see we have to draw one line. First, take any point in the middle of the line and write the 0. So it will start from 0. On the right side of 0, we have all positive numbers. On the left side of 0, we have all negative numbers. So in rational numbers, you should know about the denominator first. So here you can see 3 is the denominator. 3 is the denominator. You should have a common denominator. With the denominator 3, you can maintain a gap between two numbers. So if you want to write 1, there should be 2 point gap, 1 and 2. in this way. So here you will get 1. Here you can write, okay, we had denominator 3. So we want to have gap of 3. 1, 2 and 3. So these are the gap of number 1, 2, 3. So here you can write 1. After this we want to write 2. Then again you have to put 1, 2, 3. Here you can write 2. You want to write 3? Then draw further. 1, 2, 3. So you should have a gap of 3 numbers, 3 point, because you have denominator 3. So that is very important. To draw a number line, you should first of all know to create a gap between two numbers, 0 to 1. 1 or 0 ke beech mein 3 point ka gap hai. Kyun 3 point ka gap hai? Kyunki we had denominator 3. So we should create a gap of 3. If we have denominator 4, then 4 gap should be there. 5, then 5 gap should be there. So this, here you can have gaps. So 0 to 1 ke beech mein 3 point ka gap. Then 1 or 2 ke beech mein 3 point ka gap. Or 2 or 3 ke beech mein 3 point ka gap. Or here you can in the same way get the negatives. Negatives on the left side of 0. Here 1, 2, 3. So minus 1. Then 1, 2, 3. Minus 2. Then 1, 2 and 3. Minus 3. In this way you can draw a number line. This is a number line. Now we have to put all this rational number on this number line. So you can easily get 2 over here. 2 is already here. So this is 2. This is 2. So you have already 2 here. So here we will mark it as we had written this number 2. Then we have to find 7 upon 3. Where should 7 upon 3 comes? So start from beginning. Here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this number you can write 7 upon 3. 7 upon 3 here. So this is 7 upon 3 and this is 2. In this way you can draw number line. Here it is 7 upon 3. So here 7 upon 3, you can see 7 upon 3. Now we want to write minus 2 upon 3. Minus 2 upon 3. So on number line, you can take minus 2 upon 3. So minus 2, you have to find minus 2. So here on the left side, 1, 2. So this is minus 2. Here you can see minus 2 here also. But this is only minus 2. This is minus 2 upon 3. So here we will write in our box minus 2 upon 3. So we had plotted all 3 points. Our first point is 7 upon 3. That is here 7 upon 3. Then second 2. 2 is here. Then third wala minus 3 upon minus 2 upon 3 is here minus 2 upon 3. So you can plot all these points.